Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. This week we're at the IFA Consumer Electronics Show in Berlin, and we'll start with two new products from Samsung. The company updated its phablet lineup with the Note 4 and a new product called the Note Edge. The Edge has a sliver of curved glass to deliver news, messages, and additional functions to the phone. It has a 5.6-inch screen with a resolution of 2560 by 1440 pixels. The Note Edge's curved side can be used as a toolbar with links to commonly used applications. Users can swipe through tools and applications, including a ruler, stopwatch, stock ticker, weather, and emails. The controls for the Edge can be seen even when the phone's case is closed. The Note Edge will be available later this year to select markets, which Samsung didn't detail. Pricing wasn't announced. The company also added to its lineup of wearables with the Gear S smartwatch. It has a large 2-inch rectangular screen, and along with its wide band, it looks massive on your wrist. Rather than use Android Wear, the smartwatch employs Tizen, the company's own mobile operating system. With its own 3G radio, the watch doesn't need to be tethered to your smartphone via Bluetooth. The watch has a 300 milliamp hour battery, which Samsung says should last for 2 days under typical use, and it's water resistant for 30 minutes at a depth of up to 1 meter. It will be out in October. Staying with smartwatches, Taiwan's Asus debuted its own first smartwatch called the Zen Watch. It has a 1.6-inch OLED display with a curved and toughened Gorilla Glass face and a stainless steel body. The watch is intended to be used with a smartphone paired over Bluetooth. It has a number of tricks, such as being used as a remote viewfinder for picture taking. A ringing phone can also be silenced by covering the watch face with a hand. And a tap on the screen will force the paired phone to emit a sound, something intended to let users find phones that might be lost in a home. It's due to go on sale in September for $199. Not wanting to be left out, LG had its own smartwatch called the G-Watch R. Unlike most smartwatches we've seen, the LG version has a round face instead of a square one. The masculine-looking watch has a 1.3-inch display and is relatively light and unobtrusive. Its battery life is up to 2 days. It will be available in select markets in the fourth quarter of this year, but pricing wasn't announced. Lenovo's new Helix 2 convertible is one of the first tablets to use Intel's new Core M processor. The Helix 2 is an 11.6-inch fanless tablet that can latch onto a keyboard base and becomes a laptop. The hybrid is 12% lighter and 15% thinner than the original Helix that shipped last year. The slimmer, lighter tablet is due in part to Intel's Core M processor, which is based on the latest Broadwell architecture. The new Core M processors draw as little as 4.5 watts of power, which can extend battery life. With the keyboard dock, the Helix 2 offers 12 hours of battery life. It'll ship with Windows 8.1 in late October. It starts at $999. Microsoft this week debuted the Lumia 830, which it thinks will be able to compete with the likes of Samsung and Apple. Calling it the company's first affordable flagship, the phone will cost €330 or $430. It can shoot 4K video and will come with the latest version of Cortana, Microsoft's digital assistant. Trade shows like IFA aren't just about products that'll be out in a month or two, but what will be possible in the future. LG demoed a 98-inch 8K TV that has a resolution of 7680 by 4320 pixels to great effect with mostly slow-moving colorful images. The resolution is 16 times full HD. Unsurprisingly, LG didn't say what the TV would cost or when it would become available. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. To find out what's coming up on every week's show, be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Next week, we'll be back here at IFA, but we'll also have the big news from Apple. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next week.